What's up, Ryan? What's up, everybody? Get some. I like it. Trying to get some here. Gonna link up with Jamie Cochran from Echelon Front. Get her in here. That's the goal. If I can find her. Up. Waiting for Jamie Cochran. Anyone that wants to see a little behind the scene scenario from Echelon Front, which if you don't know about Echelon Front, I have a leadership consulting company with Leif Babban. It's called Echelon Front. Got a bunch of the guys from my old job, and that's what we do. We've been around for, I guess, 2012, which is kind of crazy. It started unofficially prior to that, but officially named and started the LLC in 2012. When did you start working with us, Jamie?
2014,
prior to the book coming out.
The book, before the podcast.
Before the podcast, mm-hmm. You were all just, you know, doing a little helping to organize travel and doing little administrative mm-hmm. things. And now you run everything on the backside. So Jamie, with everything that we do at Echelon Front, which is a lot of different stuff, a lot of working with companies all over the country, all over the world, and all the curriculum along with that, all the contracts along with that, all the logistics along with that, all the legal aspects of that, Jamie kind of runs the entire back end of the company now. So that's pretty cool. And if you guys saw some of my posts as this whole coronavirus kicked off and I was in lockdown and I'm all of a sudden working more, which seems crazy, than I was before. And I know I brought Jamie. I was like, Jamie, come into this boat of harder work. Come on over here with me. And, you know, we just did a very cool, I hate to use this word, but we did a cool pivot. Kind of like what we did at, you know, up at Origin, we started making the masks and whatnot. So that was pretty cool. And I realized really quickly, we were going to need to be able to support our clients through the interwebs. And Jamie jumped on it. And she was just calling me, kind of giving me an update of where we're at today. And so as I was talking to her, I was like, you know what? I really don't feel like explaining this to everyone. Why don't you get on Instagram Live with me and do it? So Jamie Cochran, where are we at? What do we got?
Well, first of all, let me just mention that this is my first ever Instagram Live. So thank you for that. No, you asked us, a week ago now, maybe 2 weeks ago, to start transitioning everything that we do to virtual options for our clients and our customers. And it's been a lot of work, but we are excited to launch LeadNet, which is new programming, strategic advising, online webinars, virtual keynotes, recorded video messages. And I had a great call with my team today, Jen and Lynn and Natalie from our ops team. And we're all set up and ready. We've got some good stuff coming through from clients. We're executing on this. It's up in our system so we can run these just like we previously did with on-site engagements. And it's cool to see it come together. We're actually getting some incredible feedback too from our clients on the effectiveness of being able to run virtual sessions, which is a new territory for us. And I think something will continue even when we get back up online and can be on site and in person with our clients. So excited about it.
Yeah. Well, I think one of the things that happens is everyone has been asked to start doing stuff online. Everyone in the country all of a sudden realizes that this technology, which everyone was kind of, hey, I'd rather just fly there and talk to them. And I get it. Like, there is an element of being face-to-face with people that has, that's cool. But the amount of interaction that you can have face-to-face is the same. Look at you and me right now. Like, this is, you're here and I'm here. And so it's awesome. And I think that everyone is now realizing. And once they do a couple sessions with us, they're like, oh yeah, you don't need to fly out here. And maybe we fly out there, you know, once every 3 months or something, but the other sessions, let's go virtual. We can actually spend more time with you at a lower price point. So it ends up being good for everybody. And, you know, the strategic advising, like, that's just the, the possibility to open this up of doing face-to-face meetings with leaders all over the country. You know, it used to be when I was going to do strategic advising with someone, cool, I'm flying to Chicago. Cool, I'm flying to Atlanta. Cool. Well, now people realize I don't need to fly there. I can sit and do this with someone for an hour, and we can go through what their strategic goals are. We can go through what the leadership problems are having. And it's totally viable, and it really works. And same thing with, go ahead.
If you actually remember, we stopped doing strategic advising like 2 years ago because we didn't have the capacity. You guys were on the road so much, and we had to turn down those options and those opportunities all the time because we just quite frankly couldn't manage it. And so it's cool to now bring it back on board because I think when we get back to being able to serve our clients in person, we can now package this with on-site visits and follow-ups. We can be better with our clients. We can deliver more to them. We can follow up with them in a better fashion. I'm stoked about it. I think it's a cool pivot, and that is going to be something we continue with the rest of our services, even when we get through all this.
Yeah, you know, taking advantage of technology, and it can be hard. You know, I often tell a story about using night vision goggles. And when night vision goggles first came to the SEAL teams, first of all, they weren't that great yet. And then guys would still just be kind of, well, you know, I don't know. We've never used those. And it ruins your night vision if you have night vision goggles on, meaning that when it's dark outside and you put bright tubes in your eyes of night vision, when you take them off, you can't see anything. Mm-hmm. So, you know, there was guys that like, no, I don't want to be like that. And then the technology got better, and then people realized, look, if we don't wear night vision goggles, we're idiots. It allows us to see in the dark. And so I think this is that idiot moment for us at Echelon Front saying, listen, if we don't start to utilize this technology, we're idiots. We can have so much more impact with our clients, so much more FaceTime with them, that for us to not do this would just be dumb. So it took a little external pressure. But as you know, we always like to find the good that we can when bad situations happen. So this is one of them. And anyways, you just called me up to give me that update. And I was, you know, just hearing that, you know, hearing the gigs that we already have lined up, how people are transitioning. And, you know, it's just awesome to hear. And I figured instead of just telling me, I would take this opportunity to have you just tell the world.
Well, thanks. This is a great first Instagram Live session.
Right on. You know, so EF Online, this is another example. So we have had EF Online for a while, which is our online leadership training platform, which in the past has been relatively static. You know, there's courses on there that people could take, and they're interactive courses, but they're, you know, like, hey, you go and you take the class. And, you know, as soon as this happened, I'm like, hey, this is our conduit to talk to people. And we've been doing live interaction 3 times a week. We've had massive audiences coming on. We're spending, you know, an hour and a half on those live webinars, doing Q&A with people from all over the country, some people from overseas. And again, all of a sudden I realize that we weren't taking advantage of this technology, and it's a mistake, but let's own the mistake and move forward in a positive way. So EF Online, well, you know, I was just making that transition. You know, I had just been talking to, like, hey, we need a better price point. We need to get more interactive. I was just starting to kind of talk to Leif about that. I talked to you a little bit about it, that's where I thought we needed to go. And then I just got hit in the head with the corona. Hey, idiot, you better do this right now. So it's been cool to see.
Yeah, I think a lot of companies are going to be doing that. We've always struggled with capacity. We've always struggled with not being able to manage the amount of interest that we get from clients. And so this, while forced upon us, I think is going to be a big solution for us moving forward, for sure, and help solve that issue.
Yeah, and price point for clients as well. You know, I mean, we charge a lot of money for what we do, and part of that reason is because there's a super high demand signal, and we don't have a lot of instructors, and, you know, look, I would love to say that anybody that was in the military, anybody that was in the SEAL teams could jump in and take over and run courses for Echelon Front. It's just not true. There's a certain type of person with certain experiences and certain understandings of the principles that we teach. And so we don't have a lot of instructors. And that means there's a, you know, low supply, high demand. And this is going to allow us to service more clients, and it will be awesome in the long run. So that's it.
I agree.
That's Friday.
Interesting times. That's Friday. Enjoy your weekend, Paul.
I wanted you to get this stuff done by Friday. So you called me at Friday at like 4 o'clock. So that's awesome.
We're done. We're ready though. Delivering.
Awesome. What's the website? Echelonfront.com.
Echelonfront.com. Yeah. You can hit us up at info@echelonfront.com too. And somebody from our team will get back to you guys if you have an interest in any of the virtual services we're offering.
Right on. All right, Jamie. Well, good talking to you. We'll have a nice weekend. And JP, by the way, JP hit me up and he's like, hey, over the weekend. And I just wrote back, weekend? He said he started laughing as soon as he typed it.
Awesome. I know. All Thanks these guys you. With their vacations and weekends. I don't know. The rest of us are over here working. So.
Right on.
We'll see you guys later. Have a good one.
Thanks, everybody. Appreciate it. Stay healthy. Stay safe. And we'll talk to y'all later. Out.